And joining us now is Congressman Steve Womack, running for re-election for U.S. House District 3. Congressman, thank you so much for joining us.
Great to be with you, Una, as always.
Tell us, thank you. And tell us about your re-election. Why are you seeking another term?
Well, just a continuation of the work that we've done for the last 13 years in Washington. Just, you know, the cornucopia of issues facing our country right now, how incredibly profound they are, and the fact that we need experienced leadership right now in Washington dealing with those, the constituent service piece that my office is known for. We closed over 1,000 cases last year for constituents in the 3rd District. The number of projects and the number of things that are going on in the 3rd District, from Ebbing Airfield in Fort Smith to I-49 to XNA, just the, I mean, there is a wide range of things that we have been personally engaged in and involved with, and this is a continuation of that work, and I hope that the voters of the 3rd District of Arkansas recognize that we are leading by example and that we're performing consistent with what their needs are.
Now, the Republicans have a very slim majority right now
very slim.
Congress,
yeah.
And it seems like you're losing a couple. Talk to us about that, the party situation in Congress right now, and why you feel that you need to keep your seat.
Well, first of all, you need to understand that in divided government, there is a limitation as to what you are able to impose through your legislative work. And we're going to be down to a two-seat majority. In other words, we can only lose a couple of members, and we have proven time and time again that we lose more than two members in terms of some of the votes on rules and some critical legislation. So it's going to be vitally important that we go back to Washington with a lot of unfinished business and have our conference prepared to kind of lock arms and be able to achieve some things that we have that's been elusive to us, not the least of which is border security. Also, the inflationary spirals that are hitting everyday Americans, to deal with the regulatory burdens that are coming down that are stifling business. And we're going to enter 2024 where some of the tax provisions from 2017 are going to begin to expire at the end of this year. So we have a tremendous workload ahead of us, and I think right now it requires that people have experience. It helps to have a little seniority, as we do now, and to be able to measure up to the expectations of our voters.
The border, the situation
terrible.
Is very overwhelming.
Yeah.
What's the solution? Why are we not doing more with that situation?
Well, it's primarily because we have an administration that looks at the border situation a lot differently than we look at it. We think that the border security issue is clearly one of our top two or three issues, and we need to fix it now. And we were well on our way to doing that during the Trump administration, but the Biden policies are a lot different. So HR 2, which I have supported, has a Remain in Mexico policy, issues regarding reforms to the asylum process. These are all things that are critically important. Bottom line is, you got to stop the influx. You got to make a commitment that you're not going to welcome hordes of people into your country in an undocumented way, like has been going on for the last 3 years. So that's going to be job one. I will be visiting the border in January. I will be there present and see for myself, and then engage in these policies and make them a demand, if you will, because we've been engaged in a budget fight now for several months. Put border security at the top of that list on negotiated topics. If you want if you want budget numbers at a certain level, and they do, then give us border security. And I think if we negotiate properly like that, we can get a border security package. It may not be everything we want, but I think it can go a long way towards stopping this this massive influx of illegal immigrants into our country.
So we need to stop that influx. But what about the migrants who are already here and coming in every day? What do you do with those migrants?
Well, it feeds into a much broader border security immigration reform package. And the problem, Una, has been that every time we try to do this, we try to do it in what we call a comprehensive way. Mm-hmm. We try to put everything into one package. Mm-hmm. And that just simply doesn't work. I think we're going to have to take certain pieces of it and get some victories out of it and then move on to the next topic. So as it concerns people who are already in our country, I think the first thing you got to do is you got to stop the flow. And if you can't stop the flow, nothing else will work. But once you stop the flow, then I think you can come back and get a few more policies regarding asylum, regarding, you know, particularly remain in Mexico. But for those people that are already here, I think we can reform some policies that make it possible for us to see a lot of those individuals return to their home country.
So in addition to border security, inflation, the budget, what are your two other top issues that you're focusing on in 2024?
Inflation, clearly. The everyday cost of living is going up on 3rd District Arkansans like it is all across the country. And some of this is because we got a regulatory, a hyper-regulatory environment we're in. So that's part of the issue. Part of the issue is we have just flooded over, particularly during COVID, so much money, so much government spending. And this money that has flowed in to the economy has accelerated a lot of things, so much so that inflationary spirals have really taken a toll on everyday Americans. Energy policies have been bad. And as a result of that, the cost of energy, from heating your homes to you know, putting gas in your car, all of those things have gone up. So I think inflation clearly is one of those issues. And then personally, I'm involved in the budget process, and I think we've got some we got a broken budget process. And I've been advocating for years now that we change this budget process so that we can get certainty and avoid the prospect of continuing resolutions, which is what we're under now, big omnibus packages, which is what we've been having to deal with in the past, or threats of government shutdown. Those are the kinds of things we need to be able to avoid. I think 3rd District Arkansans want somebody who is capable of leading in those discussions.
All right, Congressman Womack, thank you so much for joining us.
Honored to be with you.
U.S. Representative Steve Womack seeking another term in U.S. Congress for 2024. Thanks so much for joining us. We'll be back.